Acts chapter 16. All right? If I'm talking good today, say amen at least. I'm only going to be up in 5 minutes. Acts chapter 16. Look at verse number 25. Y'all there? Verse number 25 says, about midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God. What were they doing?
Praying and singing hymns to God.
And the other prisoners were listening to them. What were they doing?
Listening to them.
Sometimes you have to understand, when you're praising God, they may not be praying with you, but they're listening and looking, and they're watching you praise God. Now y'all quiet. That's not in your Bible. I don't know if y'all trying to read that. I'm just telling you. Sometimes, when you're praising God, they may not be praising with you, but they're listening. Mm-hmm. See, sometimes when you're praising God, your hater may not be praising God with you, but they're listening. Okay, y'all don't understand. They're really trying to figure out, Tristan, how is it that you praise God like you done lost your mind when you done lost everything you had? Now y'all don't understand. How is it that you can praise God when I know some stuff cut off in your house? I saw you go around back with a little thing and turn your water back up. Now y'all ain't never did that. But they're listening to you, praise God. They're listening. Somebody said they're listening to me. They're listening. Verse 26 says, suddenly.
Uh-huh.
Oh, y'all don't get it. See, y'all should get excited about that kind of stuff. Just shout, suddenly, suddenly. Because some of us tired of waiting on some stuff, D.D. We need some stuff to happen quick. I need some stuff to be sent to me overnight. I don't need to wait for this. My faith is big enough to believe, God, that I can get it by December 31st, 2020. Okay, now y'all don't want to say that. Suddenly. It says, suddenly. Was a violent earthquake that the foundations of the prison were shaken. I come to give a blue school to the devil today. I don't talk to him often, but I come to tell him that there's a violent earthquake taking place in the supernatural.
All right, all right.
That everybody that's locked up gonna get shaken free today. Now y'all don't understand. Shook the foundations of the prison. At once, everybody that was in prison noticed that the doors flew open.
Uh-huh.
And everyone's chains came loose.
All right, all right.
I'm trying to get out of the scripture, but you got to understand this. Let me do the electric slide and go back slow for you. It says that Paul and Silas were the only ones that were singing songs and they were praying.
All right.
Everybody else was listening.
Uh-huh.
But because they were singing and praying, God shook the foundations of the whole prison.
Everybody.
And it said that everybody that was in there, their doors opened and their chains came loose. Just slap fire with your neighbor and say, my next praise is for you. Because if you just listen to me give God praise, I promise that you can shake yourself loose. 27. The jailer woke up.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Wow. He woke up. Yeah.
My Bible must be wrong. Y'all need to give me a different kind of Bible. My Bible read kind of crazy. Tristan, give me one with pages, not this electronic stuff. Because my electronic Bible says that the jailer who was paid to watch you be bound woke up. I'm going to tell you, because they ain't going to say amen with me. 3 weeks ago, we prayed that the Lord would take you to a place where the devil couldn't get to you.
Uh-huh.
And when he figured out he couldn't find you, he went to sleep.
Amen. Yeah.
He went to sleep, everything started to shake. Verse 27 said that the jailer woke up, Didi, and when he saw the prison doors were open, it said that he took out his own weapon and he's about to kill himself because he thought that you got away.
Yeah.
It says verse 28, but.
But, Paul.
I hate when they put words right here. They didn't teach me this in seminary, but when they put a but right there, that means that nothing else before that really matters. It was happened after that. See, whenever they put a but right there, see, but my God shall. See, no matter what happened before, it's about what comes after the but. Y'all know what I'm saying? Some of y'all need to rejoice because you was in a relationship with a but. It don't matter what happened then. It's about what comes after the but.
Yes,
my Bible says, give me a real Bible so I can read from now. But Paul shouted.
Uh-huh.
Oh, man, y'all missed it. It's going down 6 feet. Why y'all so slow today? But iCrave said, listen, dude, don't harm yourself.
All right.
We still here. Verse 29, the jailer called for the lights. He said, come the lights on. Turn the lights on. Uh-huh. He rushed in, and he fell trembling at iCrave's feet.
Uh-huh.
Verse 30 says,
yeah.
he didn't What must I do to be saved? And scholarships and everything else, but you don't get that excited when somebody gets saved. My Bible tells me that all of heaven rejoices when one man comes to Christ. But you mean to tell me that you're gonna be locked in jail, and because you're in the middle of a mess, they're gonna come to you and say, "What must I do to be saved?"
All right.
Let me just read, because y'all don't read. Verse 31. They replied, "D.D., believe in the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved."
And
that.
Yes, God.
They didn't say, bring no money.
Uh-huh.
They didn't say any of that kind of stuff.
You're right.
Let me back up again. Uh-huh. Believe in the Lord Jesus. Who?
Lord Jesus.
Believe in your husband.
No.
Uh-huh.
Believe in your boss man.
All right.
Believe in Social Security.
All right.
But believe in what the doctor gonna say.
Uh-huh.
It says, believe in the Lord Jesus.
Yes, God.
And you will be saved. You and your household. Oh man, that's just not gotta go slow because this thing good right here. You and your house. He said, listen, you believe in the Lord Jesus.
Uh-huh.
And you will be saved and your household. Because as for me and my house, we that's for three of y'all that's worried about what they doing at the household. You ain't gotta worry about what they doing. You just lift up Jesus. Guess what? Says this. At that hour of the night, the jailer took them and he washed their wound. You mean to tell me that the enemy had cut you up and he gonna come back and get you,
get saved, then take you
and mend you up?
Y'all don't want to say that right now.
Here it is. Then it's just like, but then, immediately, he and all his household were baptized. 34 says this. The jailer brought them into his house and set a meal before them. They're still missing it.
Make your enemies your food.
The enemy brought me into his house.
Yes, sir.
And made some food for me.
Yes.
The hater that talked about me last week brought me to their house. Got me a meal, fixed it, and set it before me. Y'all don't want to say that. In the Bible, Rebecca, anybody that was set, a meal was set before them means that they were of higher authority. You know, if you ate with the king, they set the meal before you. Somebody served you. You didn't just come in and walk through a buffet line. So it says that the jailer brought them into the house and set a meal before. Y'all Bible reading like I read? All our Bible messed up. It says he was filled with joy because he had come to believe in God. Anybody know you was real excited when you got saved? But some of y'all busters been saved for 26, 27, 37 years, and now you just lame, and your fire just done died down, the passion just done died down, because you just looking at God like a sugar daddy. But I decree today that the fire is going to be reignited. That there'll be a new zeal for God, that there's going to be a new, a freshness. That same zeal that you had when you first got saved, you won't have that after you leave today. You ain't going to know what's wrong with you. You're just going to say, all week long, like Mother Wright, I just been on fire. I don't know what's happening. There's something that's taking place. Because when I think of the goodness of Jesus, I'm preaching to y'all. I ain't going to say nothing. And everything that he's done for me, my soul cries out. I thank God for saving me. Let me read the scripture. I should have had somebody else to read it. We would have been done. Verse 35 says, when it was daylight, the magistrates, the judges, not one judge, the magistrates sent their officers to the jail with the order to release those men.
All right.
I gotta take you down through there again, Monica, because they're not getting it. They were not there when they were singing and saw the earthquake. But when God does something for you, you got to go tell somebody what happened. So somebody went and told the magistrates that, listen, there's some dudes that were singing some church songs and praying. The earthquake came. They didn't leave. See, y'all missed that right there. Because what you'll do is if the prison door is open, you'll take off running. But integrity says stay there because that's where you are for the moment. Oh, y'all missed that. Whatever you in right now is just for a moment. Because weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. In the morning. It says, 6 and we'll stop here. The jailer told Paul, the magistrates, the chief authority, the judges have ordered that you and Silas be released.
Yes.
Now you can leave and go in peace. Just touch your neighbor and say, go in peace. Go in peace. Just slap call with three people and tell them, go in peace. Go in peace. As long as they ain't stuck up, just tell them, go in peace. Come on, come on. Everybody should slap call with somebody and tell them, go in peace.
Go in peace.
Because you've been released already.
Yes,
you just got to get in your mind that you ain't locked up no more. Subject, shake it like a salt shaker. Just touch your neighbor and say, shake it like a salt shaker. Now look at me, do like this. But beloved, when you understand that you are the salt of the world, you understand that every time you come around, there comes an essence of flavor.
All right.
A piece of chicken is nothing without a little bit of salt.
Yeah.
Collard greens, as good as they are, they're nothing unless you got a little bit of salt on them, y'all. And because you are the salt of the earth, that means that you have the flavor to bring about the kingdom of God to the earth. So we have found ourselves at a point or another, or a place of being locked up or locked down by something or someone, or by the way we react was resolved for getting free or busting loose. So just tell yourself, I feel like busting loose. I know I'm talking good, so just give me a couple of amens and we'll be out of here in 6 minutes. Relationship held you down. You couldn't move forward because you thought you couldn't do what you wanted to do. Or you couldn't make it without that joker until God moved him or her and showed you that I was and I am the source of your blessing. You cherish that job. You worship that job. And sometimes you worship the God that said, you said, gave you the job. You weren't supposed to be in the first place, so you're gonna put yourself back in bondage, back in jail, back in prison. But you understand, this time when I go back, I got a handle being locked up, and when I get out this time, who the Son sets free is free. Thank you, God, church. Now, so we find ourselves in the text, understanding that I got a handle being locked up properly, but we must adopt the mentality that doors are opening. So I know you're tired of your neighbor. Look at somebody else that you ain't looked at yet and just tell them doors are opening.
Yes, God. Doors are opening.
Doors, Joseph, doors are opening.
Yes,
Mark, doors are opening. Get eating. Doors. Niece, doors are opening. Verse 25 said this, Bella. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. The first one that I want to tell you so you know that I'm hermeneutically astute is timing is key in getting your miracle. Timing is key for those that are writing and getting your miracle. I'll say it one more time, Kim, so you can get it. Timing is key for getting your miracle. The Bible says about midnight. Y'all missed that right
there. All right.
Shucks.
All right.
Midnight is that in-between time from yesterday and today. See, that in-between time, Rebecca, can be some mean times, but in-between yesterday and today is midnight. That means things are turning around. I'm preaching already. So there was a story of a man that was blind, and he was crying out for Jesus, and it was the time for him to be healed. So he figured out, listen, I've been crying out for this long, begging for stuff, but if I just scream a little bit louder while Jesus is here, I can be healed. Excited like me. I don't know what's going on with me. I'm just out of control. Just touch your neighbor and say, he's out of control.
He's out of control.
So this whole party is out of control. Yeah, y'all don't like that. Okay. So always praise God, even if your neighbor don't.
All right.
That's the point number two. I don't know what y'all talking about in Sunday school, but I just felt something just jerk on me. Always praise God, even when your neighbor don't.
Amen.
Let me say it again, because two of y'all caught it. Always praise God. Even if your neighbor don't, why, Pastor? Why? Because it's you that needs the blessing. It says, they praise God. Paul and Silas praise God. That's what my Bible says, verse 25. And then it goes down and it says, suddenly. Y'all didn't cut that yet. Suddenly, quickly. Without tarrying, without waiting, suddenly. Oh, shucks. Somebody that been locked up, because when they used to open the gates, if I had on handcuffs and shackles, that didn't fall off.
All right.
So me being who I am, on my way here, I said, God, why is it that the chains had to fall off and the doors had to be open? He said, because what happens sometimes is I open doors and people are scared to walk outside the door into the hallway. I said, okay. He said, listen, if the doors had just been open, son, what would have happened, Angie, is they would have thought that it was a mistake by the jailers. And they would have gave my glory to the man that was asleep. Okay, y'all don't want to see that. He said, so when the gates opened and the chains fell off, everybody had to look and say, this had to be God, because I wasn't even praising. I didn't even ask him for this blessing. I didn't even ask him for this miracle. But my mama was praying and my sister was praying. Suddenly, that feel good. Every time I say it, that feel good. Suddenly, somebody believe in God for some quick stuff. You need some stuff to turn around quick. Suddenly, I need this stuff to happen. Alabama Power on their way, but suddenly, I believe that God can do it. I don't know how he gonna do it, but suddenly. Suddenly, when you figure out how to get God's attention, he comes to aid you suddenly. But you got to first figure out how to get his attention.
Right.
But the problem is, some of us come in and you got to be dragged into a position to get attention.
Right.
And it's almost like this. If I'm the money man and I got all the money, and then but three of y'all came up here and said, thank you, can I have it? I appreciate it. Shook my hand. The rest of y'all sitting there waiting on me to throw it out there and make it rain. You ain't going to get it, but I'm going to give it to the person that's up here working for it.
All right.
So everybody get in the world like me. Because even in the world, when I was in the world throwing money places that I shouldn't have been, they had to work for it. Okay, y'all don't want to see that tonight. Y'all ask for a real pastor, man. When I get real, you don't want me to be real no more. You got to work for what you want, and your work comes through your praise. Okay. Uh-oh, y'all remember grandma used to say, when praises go up, blessings come down. But if you don't put no praise into the atmosphere, you just sitting there, hungry, won't open your mouth, looking crazy and frustrated, talking about God ain't blessing me. Yeah. He got blessings for you just won't ask for.
All right.
yes, goodness.
It happens suddenly, at once. Suddenly.
Suddenly.
Let me give you this right here, because y'all tripping. There's a major difference between an earthquake and a natural disaster.
All right.
If I'm wrong, Timothy, you throw me a peppermint up here and I'll stop. Whenever there's an earthquake, there's a shake from the bottom. Mm-hmm. And it shakes everything from the bottom to the top. And that which was on the top is on the bottom.
Wow.
And that which was on the bottom goes to the top.
Amen. Wow.
See, I was tripping. I was tripping actually because I was trying to figure out why folks don't like you. I'm talking to Ashley, but the rest of them will get in a minute. I was trying to figure out why folks don't like you. They don't like you because you're an earthquake.
Oh, yeah.
When you come around, you shake up some stuff. Yeah. Folks don't like being around you because when they left you, you was on the bottom, but oh, they thought that you were going. Okay, now I'm gonna say that. They thought all the hell that you was going through, all the stuff that you was going through, in reality, God was shaking up some stuff. Somebody say, shake it like a salt shaker. Feel something different in the atmosphere. It was the same stuff on you that he had to get off of you. And because you had some stuff on you, oh shucks, and he had to get it off you, what he had to do is shake. Okay, y'all don't want to say nothing. Y'all ain't excited. This is the saga of the dirty blanket. When you got a dirty blanket that got cookies on it, y'all don't want to say nothing. Some of y'all don't know how to eat in the bed. If you got a dirty blanket that got some dirt on it, before you put it on you, you just don't put it on you with cookie crumbs because you will be uncomfortable. But you have to shake it and tell yourself, I'm going to keep shaking until some stuff come off of me. I'm going to keep shaking until things get better. I'm going to keep shaking until I ain't scared no more because I am the head and not the tail. I'm going to keep shaking until I get all that I got to get from God. Somebody say, shake. Come on, help me preach this. Say, shake it. Some stuff off. Yeah. In my shaking, the doors are opening.
Uh-huh.
And in my shaking, some foolishness is getting better.
Yeah. Yeah.
Listen, everybody can praise God for a blessing. Everybody can give God praise for a blessing. But who can praise God for the hell you in?
Yeah.
The hell that you've been through. Because you look at it and say, yes, I'm being shaken. Yes, I'm dizzy. I'm dizzy from this ride. Yes, he shook some folks out of my life that I love. Yes, he shook all this stuff that I wanted and I got rid of it. Y'all ain't saying nothing. But you say, don't stop shaking until I get better. Don't stop shaking until I see better. Don't stop shaking me until things in my life are better. Somebody say, shake me. There was an earthquake. And immediately, all the doors were open. And verse number 25, it says the prisoners were listening. The prisoners were listening. Verse number 25 says the prisoners were listening. Okay, y'all ain't gonna say nothing. It says the prisoners were listening. Y'all missed that. The same people that was in the same mess that you were going through was watching you because you said that God was able, and because you said God was able, they didn't move, but they watched. Okay, they don't want to say nothing. You trying to figure out, why am I still in the middle of this mess? Because he's letting the other prisoners watch you. It says that the prisoners didn't join in. It never said that the prisoners praised for themselves.
Wow.
Amen.
But because you were in the atmosphere or in the same place with me,
yes.
See, everybody don't need a shout.
Amen.
Everybody don't need a shout.
All right.
Everybody on your road don't have to shout. But if we could just get some shout captains, y'all ain't saying that. I'm going to go there for everybody on my road, and I'm going to praise God until the doors open for everybody on my road. Y'all don't want to say nothing now. See, the thing about it, the captain shouting is now heaven representing everybody on your team. Just high five your neighbor and say, pick me. I'm talking about if you're a praiser for real. If you ain't no praiser, don't say this. But the thing about being the captain is, But I feel it. Yeah. Oh, Tristan, don't give me an opportunity. Shake this, shake, shake.
Can I get about 30 people?
It's okay, just shake it, shake it, move.
I just need one on every row on each side.
That's it. One captain, that's all I need. That's it. From every row, shake for your name.
My dad says your praise.
Come on, sing it out. Sing it. Y'all ain't heard a preacher preach that.
Your praise signifies that your faithfulness is
all over here. Stop. Listen, you have 6 seconds to believe that. You don't mess around and let the devil talk you out of what you're supposed to get. You're talking about that's too big for God. What do you mean that's too big for God? He says, I do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that you can ask me. Take them. Shake, shake, shake. They don't believe it. He said, I'm going to give you press down. Shake it all, shut.
Thank God for God shaking.
Yeah.
Yeah, it made you dizzy. It made you sick. You felt like you had shaking baby syndrome, but guess what? He was shaking some stuff, moving some stuff around. Stuff that was on the bottom is now on the top. For I am the head. And see, y'all don't understand how to read the scripture. It says you are the head and not the tail. Your cousin them called you, what you call it? But you can look at them now and say, you call me that, but I'm ahead. Oh, shucks. Y'all will catch that tomorrow in the toilet time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come here, shepherd.